बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कवर अ टॉपिक ऑफ फॉरेंसिक मेडिसिन। ड्राउनिंग और डेथ ड्यू टू ड्राउनिंग। फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ दिस प्रॉब्लम ऑफ ड्राउनिंग? Drowning is quite common in our country and thousands of deaths occur per annum due to drowning, and it is said to be the fourth leading cause of accidental death in the world. What is drowning? It is death resulting from immersion in a fluid and inhaling it. This fluid or medium can be water. Most commonly, in 99% of cases, the medium or fluid is water, but drowning can occur in other media as well. For example, acid in oil and in milk. Mechanism of drowning. Death due to drowning, when it occurs, the mechanism is quite complex. Death may be due to asphyxia, but other modes and other mechanisms are also involved, which we will study when we study this topic in detail. Deep drowning occurs in sea, in river, and in canals, but an unconscious person, an intoxicated person, can drown himself even in shallow water, even in a bathtub. Types of drowning. There can be typical drowning and atypical drowning. Drowning is said to be typical when water or any other fluid enters the air passages, goes up to lungs, and there are typical findings of drowning on autopsy examination. This typical drowning is also called wet drowning. Then there is atypical drowning. In atypical drowning, water does not enter the air passages, but the dead body is recovered from canal or river. Either water or fluid is not inhaled, or very little fluid is inhaled, and cause of death is different. For example, if a person falls in a river or jumps from a height into a river where the water is very cold, and that cold water strikes his body and he goes into vasovagal shock, there is a vagal inhibition, and suddenly death occurs, it is called dry drowning or immersion syndrome. Water does not enter the body. In this case, death occurs due to vasovagal shock. And if we do autopsy in such cases, we will not find typical findings of rat drowning in the lungs. Similarly, if somebody inhales cold water which goes into his nasal orifices and also goes through the throat up to the larynx and laryngeal spasm occurs. When laryngeal spasm occurs, neither air can enter beyond that nor water. In this case, death will occur due to asphyxia because of lack of oxygen. And on autopsy examination, there will be typical findings of asphyxial death. Another type of atypical drowning is submersion of an unconscious person. When the person is unconscious because of epileptic attack, because of intoxication, because of ischemic heart disease, because of head injury, and he falls in water, then entry of fluid into the air passages will be very slow and we will have modified findings. So this is also an atypical type of drowning. Then there is a term, secondary drowning syndrome. Secondary drowning syndrome is the term. It is used when a person is rescued from water and he is provided resuscitative measures. He improves. His breathing is smooth and he is conscious, but suddenly he deteriorates, his condition deteriorates, he develops respiratory distress, there is a fall in blood pressure and cardiac arrhythmias occur and he may die due to this. This is due to anoxia and due to fatigued cardiac muscles and due to cerebral ischemia. This condition is called secondary drowning syndrome. Drowning can occur in fresh water, like in canal, in river, and drowning can occur in sea water. Mechanism of death is different in freshwater drowning and seawater drowning. Mechanism of drowning. Studies were made in animals. When animals were thrown in water, they showed some voluntary holding of breath. Naturally, it was followed by deep breathing and they inhaled some water every time. There were some muscular movements. The animal tried to get out of water. With forced inspiration, more and more water entered into respiratory passages. And in the expired breath, there was fine froth stained with blood. Later, there was loss of consciousness and muscular twitchings, dilatation of pupils, and death due to respiratory failure. Almost same mechanism occurs in human beings when the person falls in water. He tries to withhold his breath. Naturally, he has to take deep breath. Some more water goes inside his respiratory passages, and he has to do it again and again till the time he becomes unconscious and dies due to lack of oxygen. His dead body may come to the surface after 48 hours or so. Now, fresh water drowning, meaning thereby drowning in a river or in a canal. When person dies due to fall in a river or canal, the water, when he enters water enters into his respiratory passages. Absorption of water takes place through alveolar membranes. There is an increase in blood volume. Sudden, violent, abrupt increase in blood volume takes place, and there is increase up to 50% of the blood volume. This leads to electrolyte and osmotic imbalance within few minutes. This leads to acute cardiac failure. There is a lysis of RBCs, hemolysis takes place due to sudden hypotonicity of plasma. Potassium is released. There is hyperkalemia once hemolysis takes place. Death in case of freshwater drowning is due to hyperkalemia, cardiac arrhythmias, and ventricular fibrillation. But in seawater drowning, in seawater, concentration of sodium chloride is much more. It is up to 3%. Seawater is hypertonic. When seawater enters the lungs, it draws fluid towards the lung because of process of osmosis, and there is pulmonary edema. Salt travels towards circulatory system, and there is hemoconcentration. If immersion continues for more than few minutes, anoxic changes supervene, and there is slow cardiac failure. Death in seawater drowning occurs in about 8 minutes time, but death in freshwater drowning, where there is sudden abrupt increase in blood volume, death occurs in 3 to 5 minutes time. But in death due to seawater drowning, person can survive up to 8 minutes and there is time to take resuscitative measures and try to save his life. Before going further, I will show you the picture differentiating seawater drowning and freshwater drowning. You can see sequence of events in freshwater drowning. Water is entering the lungs through the alveoli. In freshwater drowning, there is massive absorption through alveoli, leading to hypervolemia, hemolysis, hyperkalemia, leading to acute cardiac failure, cardiac arrhythmias, and ventricular fibrillation, leading to death. While in case of salt water drowning, because salt water, sea water is concentrated, contains a lot of sodium chloride, because of process of osmosis, pulmonary edema develops, water is drawn towards the lungs, and there is hemoconcentration, there is no hemolysis. There is gradual cardiac failure in this case as opposed to freshwater drowning, and death occurs in about 8 minutes time. Autopsy findings when death is due to drowning. First, external autopsy findings. Froth is very, very typical in antemortem drowning. Froth comes from nose and mouth. It is fine, leathery, white, enormous in amount, and it is very tenacious. You remove it and it is there. You remove it, you just compress the chest and it is there. So it is produced in enormous amount. Froth from nose and mouth can also come in few other conditions, in few other deaths. For example, death due to opium poisoning, death due to organophosphate compound poisoning. But in such cases, it is not fine, it is not leathery, it is not large in amount. Just small amount comes from nose and mouth in cases of organophosphate compound poisoning death or death due to opium poisoning. In case of drowning, it is enormous in amount and it is fine, leathery, quite typical. You can also observe presence of reeds or mud tightly clenched in the hands of the victim. This is due to cadaveric spasm. This is also antemortem phenomenon. This clearly indicates that the person was alive when he entered water. That is why he tried to save himself and reeds were tightly clenched in his hands because of cadaveric spasm. Typical fine leathery froth copious in amount coming from nose and mouth of a victim of drowning. Another picture shows white froth, large in amount, coming from the nose of the victim of drowning. Continuing with autopsy findings, clothes and body is wet, soiled by mud, sand or weeds, face may be cyanosed, you can see wrinkles, bleaching and sodden appearance of hands and feet. This is called washerwoman's appearance. These are external findings in death due to drowning. Internal findings in death due to drowning, typical findings are in the respiratory tract. The lungs, they are large, voluminous, ballooning of lungs. They are so much enlarged that you can observe impression of ribs on the surface of the lungs. If you cut these lungs, blood-stained froth will come out. So these are typical findings of wet drowning in the lungs. Biochemical changes in blood also give an idea whether death is due to drowning or not. Mr. Gattler suggested that we can diagnose drowning on the basis of these biochemical changes. According to Mr. Gattler, if there is difference of 25 milligrams per cent chloride on both sides of heart, right side of heart and left side of heart, if there is difference of more than 25 milligram per cent chloride contents, death is due to drowning. Similarly, if water is present beyond stomach in intestine, it also confirms death due to drowning. If a dead body is thrown in water, water can go up to stomach, but it cannot go beyond stomach. So if water is present in intestine, if water is present in middle ear cavity, it confirms death due to drowning. Another confirmation for the death due to drowning is presence of diatoms. Diatoms are unicellular algae. Their wall is made of silicone, which resists acid digestion and process of putrefaction. They make colonies. Striations are present on them, and these unicellular algae or diatoms, if recovered from brain, liver, bone marrow, they also confirm that death is due to drowning. If a dead body is thrown in water, diatoms can go into respiratory passages. diatoms can go into esophagus. So it means nothing. But when diatoms are recovered from brain, liver, kidneys or bone marrow, this confirms that death was due to drowning. This confirms that when the person entered water, his circulation was intact. That is why these diatoms went up to brain, liver and bone marrow. But you have to rule out other causes of death as well. This picture shows various types of diatoms. These are unicellular organisms, microscopic organisms present in water, showing striations. Their wall is of silicon, which resists process of putrefaction, and action of acid is also not on this wall. This diagram shows on the left side the circulation when it is intact, circulatory system is functioning, person enters water, water from heart can go to kidneys, can go to bone marrow, can go to brain, can go to liver, and if diatoms are recovered from these places, it means cause of death is ante-mortem drowning. It confirms that person's circulatory system was intact when he entered water. On right side, where the circulatory system is not intact when the person entered water, you will not find diatoms in bone marrow, in kidney, in brain or in liver. Diatoms can only go up to respiratory passages, maybe up to lungs. But you will not be able to recover diatoms from kidneys, bone marrow or brain. While doing autopsy in a suspected case of drowning, you should collect blood sample and send it for chemical analysis to ensure that person did not take any sedative or he was not taking any anti-epileptic drug. Medico-legal importance. Drowning is antemortem or otherwise. You have to decide it. Drowning is antemortem. We can decide on external findings and on internal findings. External findings are typical froth coming from nose and mouth and cadaveric spasm. Internal findings are typical findings of wet drowning in the lungs, water beyond stomach, water in middle ear cavity, and recovery of diatoms from bone marrow, from brain and kidney, etc., confirms that death was due to antemortem drowning. Drowning can be suicidal, homicidal or accidental. Accidental is the most common cause. Homicidal cannot be ruled out, you have to rule it out. And if it is suicidal, then one may write suicidal note, and you should also do psychological autopsy in such cases. determination of time since death in a case of drowning. At times, if the person is wearing wrist watch, his watch just stops when he enters the water. You can note down the time since death from observing that watch. Cooling is more rapid in water. Process of putrefaction is rather slow in water. But once the dead body is brought out of water, process of putrefaction occurs very, very rapidly. Accidental drowning is quite common. Rather, the most leading cause of accidental death is drowning. This is also a case of drowning. Shallow water drowning can occur in a bathtub, especially if the person is intoxicated or he has taken alcohol or he is suffering from epilepsy. Accidental drowning is more common in children. Well, we have covered the topic of drowning. Important questions, important SEQs from this topic are: what are sure signs of ante-mortem drowning? Another SEQ can be: what is typical drowning and what is atypical drowning and what is dry drowning? Well, we stop here. Thank you very much.